Hello, it's Andy Gailey again from Uptime Consultant Limited and Uptime Consultant Academy. This is going to be a short video just to as a comparison between two M-series HIKMICRO thermal imagers kindly lent to me by a company called CBM Partners. Now, they are both the same form factor instrument. The M11 here is 660 grams in weight, and the M60 is about 685 grams in weight. There's about 25 grams between them. Other than that, they're all the same form factor. The difference is that the imagers, so the sensors, are obviously different. So when we look at a sensor, we're looking for the size of aperture there. So the one on the left, the M11, very small, 192 by 144. And then we've got the larger sensor in the M60 on the right. So let's just close those covers, because one thing we don't want to do is ever put our fingers near there. Now, I've got these set on two images we captured the other day in a client's premises of mine, who took up the offer of half a day's free thermal imaging training, and in return myself and four engineers from utilities went out on the shop floor and we took some images together. Now, these were taken side by side. The time's slightly different on the M11, it's about 10 minutes out, but they were taken side by side at the same time. I've got the physical image of this taking place as well, and you can see the field of view. Now, this one, we're 1.5 meters away, and this is perfect in that we can see the full motor, gearbox, cowling, all of the things we want to see, control box. This one, we barely see a third of that asset, because the field of view at 19 by 14 is way, way too tight. This one, more like 42 by 38, from the top of my head, that kind of range, 40 by 40. We're getting a really good field of view. So that's the difference, I want to say, between these two images. Plus, this one is almost a quarter of the price of this one. So this is what you pay for. You pay for field of view, and you also pay for resolution. This one's very small resolution, more like a pocket camera, pocket thermal imager. This one is what I would say an engineer in an industrial setting needs. We need clarity and we need that resolution. So that's the quick kind of comparison. Other than that, the two images are the same. They both come in a case with two batteries. They both come with chargers. If you want to find out more about these, I'm sure that the people that sent me these from CBM Partners Ltd here in the UK might be interested in talking to you, because they are, by the time this video goes out, they are going to be dealing with HIKMICRO here in the UK. So if you want to find out any more about Uptime Consultant, you can look at the website here on the mouse map. You can also search me on LinkedIn. I'm there active every day. And yeah, thanks for looking at the short video. There's other videos that go more into depth, but this is one I wanted to do to compare these two devices to make sure that people don't go and purchase something that disappoints them. This one as well, the training I did, two half-day full kind of mornings, they were with four utilities and asset care engineers, so eight in total. And everybody, after we'd done the demonstrations and played with these for an hour and a half and did the training, said they would like to take this one. So that's the feedback we got. The other one we looked at as well the other day was a small form factor Pocket E from HIKMICRO. So there's a video on that if you want to go and look at it. There's one apparently I haven't seen, but there's one that's called Pocket 2. And it's got a much more useful resolution than this one. This is a starter instrument that gives you 96 by 96 resolution. It boosts it with Super IR, so you can, it boosts it times two, I think. LED lights really useful. Lots of engineers commented on this, said they wanted that on their existing thermal imager. IR imager here and visual lens there. Only two buttons. There's on off, there's a capture button, and if you press it longer, you get video. And everything is controlled via the touchscreen. There's a video on that, go and have a look. Again, thanks for your time, and look out for more videos in the future.